MB2 Raceway. Iowa's premier go-karting experience is the perfect place for birthday parties, company team-building events, and holiday parties. Our 40,000-square-foot indoor facility caters to large and small groups. To book events or for information, visit mb2raceway.com.
Laser 103.3.
It's the Morning Moose Show. Hello, everybody. How's everybody doing today?
How are you, Heather?
Pretty good, Moose.
Yeah. See that cup of orange liquid in front of you?
I'm not drinking it.
Drink the Doritos Flavored Mountain Dew.
I'm not doing it.
Drink it. Do you want this job or not?
I didn't do it.
Gypsy, drink it.
Yeah. Gross. You're Gypsy, right?
Okay, I'll sip it to taste the flavor, but so I'm not drinking this whole cup.
Just try it.
That is, that's disgusting.
That was a pho, yes. By the way, for the record.
Yeah.
That was so, how was it?
Yeah, it was not a swear.
That was not a swear.
It's not that bad.
Was that it? Was an exclamation.
What'd you think?
Just take a big old pull off.
No, that was.
Cannonball. Cannonball. Come. It's Veterans Day. Do it for the troops.
Oh, the troops wouldn't do this.
No. Even like.
Wowie, kazowie.
Even like in wartime with. No rations left.
I love America, so.
B-Sucks is drinking more of it. You are going to die later.
Oh. No, he's going to blow mud.
Doing it for the truth.
He's going to blow mud.
Like a champ.
Oh, God, that was bad sitting in there for a while.
America. Oh, no. America.
Yeah. So, oh. Heather R.
I think that was a bad choice.
Land of the brave.
Heather R., I'm going to call you Heather R.
I have Dorito Mountain Dew in my beard now.
I think you're going to turn into eventually loving it, B-Sucks. You seem to like it's growing on you.
This is how I start my whole morning all the time.
Watching, like, in a couple hours, you'll see some, like, elbows in your stomach. Like you're pregnant with some sort of weird Dorito Mountain Dew baby.
It's probably not going to happen.
No, probably not.
Might not have to come to work tomorrow.
Enough about B-Socks.
Let's talk about Heather R., who you can text to vote for at RG6 to 77,000. Now, you're a gypsy?
I am.
What does that mean? Like, is this like a lineage thing? Or are you just, like, I'm a gypsy, man. You can't peg me down.
Well,
I'm all over the place.
Yes, it's just like that. No, the past couple of years, I've just been traveling around, checking everything out.
Traveling where? Where'd you go?
Well, let's see. Mostly, this year, I was living mostly out in Myrtle Beach. I went down to Florida for a second. Ended up hooking up with Full Throttle Saloon. Went out to South Dakota. And,
Were you a bartender there?
I was.
Yeah, I think I remember that from our initial interview.
Yes, I was.
How long
was.
Did you bartend at Full Throttle Saloon?
I just started this year in Sturgis.
Do you go there every Sturgis rally?
I will now.
Yeah?
I will now.
Good money in that?
Yeah, it's decent. I will never miss another Sturgis bike rally, ever.
Why?
It is such a good time. The people there are nuts. It's so much fun.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Next year's the 75th anniversary, too. It's going to be massive.
Oh, it's going to be huge.
Oh, huge. I'm so excited for that.
My goal, huge.
I hear it's going to be huge.
My goal is to have my own bike before I go out next year.
Yeah.
So hopefully in the next 8 months.
Do you ride? Do you have a license?
I don't have a license. But easily obtainable, though. Easy enough.
Yeah. So you're going to get it and get up to Sturgis for 75th.
Yes,
and then you're
definitely.
Do you get to booze it up while you're working that bar?
No.
No? Do they have strict rules about that? Because everything you see, it's like, it's time to get down no matter where you are. You're going to get drunk. But if you're behind the bar, it's no drinks.
Well, you're not supposed to.
Oh, okay.
Most bartenders aren't supposed to anywhere, but, you know.
But the hot chicks, they let it slide, right?
Well, because
what are you wearing, like a leather bikini top or something like that?
All kinds of fun stuff. The buttless chaps, since I can't use swear words.
Yeah.
Buttless chaps.
You can say assless chaps.
Oh, I can?
Yeah.
Oh.
Let's just
keep it clean.
All kinds of fun leather stuff.
What's your dream bike? What would you, if you could, money no object, what would you ride?
Gosh, I don't even know. I just have a soft spot for shovelheads because that's the first family bike that I grew up on.
Okay.
Really? I think next year I want to start out with the trike, though.
That's for old guys.
No, it's not.
Yeah.
Trikes are kind of, I think of them as like luxury bikes.
Really?
Yeah.
Just get a car.
How about those reverse trikes?
The spider? The
Can-Am
spider?
Those just look futuristic. So.
I'm not a fan of those.
There was
a brief period
where I wanted one of those, then I quickly got over it. That's kind of how I feel now. So anyway, you want to get on your hog and go to Sturgis. Now, Myrtle Beach. I've been to Myrtle Beach. That's a dirt hole. That's White Trashville there. Would you agree?
White Trashville? No, it's a melting pot. Everybody is from everywhere.
Gypsy.
Yeah.
Don't put a curse on me.
Don't make me light a candle. When you're in Florida, did you instantly notice the stupidity going on there?
In Florida?
Yeah.
Oh, I started off in South Beach, Miami, so yeah.
Like, what was the craziest thing you saw or did in Florida? Ooh. Because all the stupid news stories, well, I shouldn't say all, but about 70% of them.
I mean, I don't see anybody on bath salts eating people's faces or anything like that.
Not even that extreme. I mean, it's just ass backwards down there. Did you see anything like that? Did you even see a guy literally walking ass backwards, maybe?
Three. I seen three of them.
Yeah.
No. Everybody's really diverse down there, so you can find just about anything, a little bit of everything.
So you're from Muscatine, though?
I am.
Okay. Mm-hmm. What made you want to go travel and see different things?
Well, if you grow up in small town Iowa your whole life, you know, you're just like, man, there's so much more out there. Cabin fever, got to get out of here, check things out.
What inspired you to get the bone in your nose?
The bone? That is not a bone. That is metal.
Okay. Potato. The piercing in your nose.
I don't know.
Because that's an unusual piercing, typically.
Yeah.
You think so?
Yeah.
I don't know. I think any metal you put in your bottle is...
It's no Mountain Dew or Doritos.
I know, right? I just drink sloppy Doritos and soaked in Mountain Dew. I'm not judging.
I almost, you know, when I first got it, I almost considered it like a social experiment, you know, because I know how, at that time I was working at a nightclub, so I know how everybody talks to me, acts towards me when I'm all dressed up, makeup done, all that stuff. You know, everybody's really sweet. But if I start to do things like that or put on the weird piercings, people are like, ooh. You know, it's just nice to see how people react differently.
So you like the attention, but then you don't like it.
No, I like to see how people react to me.
Okay.
So do you wear it all the time?
Most of the time, yeah.
What other piercings do you have?
I took most everything out for rugby. My favorite piercing I had was my nape.
Is that the navel area?
No, that's your neck, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. Rugby. You played rugby?
Yeah. Yep.
Like, is this like a co-ed or a girl league or what?
No, not co-ed. It's, women's. It's all women's.
And it's full-on brawling, kick-ass rugby, right?
Just fist fights on the field.
Seriously?
Everywhere.
It's not like flag football.
I think I mean, we don't have padding here. Yeah. It's pretty much put in a mouth guard and go.
Wow. You seem like a tough babe. Like, you can throw a punch if you had to.
I mean, if I really had to, I could probably figure it out.
Do I have a punchable
face?
Don't
threaten me with a good time.
What?
I'm just saying, don't threaten me with a good time. I'm not really a morning person, and no, I'm just kidding.
Interesting edge to you. I like it, but I'm scared. Heather R. in the $40,000 Rock Girl search. Vote for her RG6 to 77,000. Are you going to be at Audio Labs on Saturday?
Of course. Okay. I will be everywhere at every event.
Audio Labs is on Ingersoll Avenue, by the way.
Great place. Great
stop by there. It's right across the media complex.
Really? I love that place.
Going in there is like God hugging you.
Heather, it's a pleasure seeing you.
Nice to talk to all of you guys.
And good luck the rest of the way in the $40,000 Rock Girl search.
Well, thank you much.